In this video episode, I'm going to discuss on how to use the Kuretsu Q1021R digital multimeter for our motor control activities. Aside from Sanwa analog multimeter which we usually use in our activities, we also need to familiarize ourselves in using this type of multimeter. We need to identify the parts of this instrument. First, function switch, it is where you can select the appropriate testing range for your task. For the meantime, let's select AC volt range to turn on the equipment. This is the LCD or just simply our display, this is where readings take place. Next, the select key, REL or max min key and hold or backlight key. I'll discuss the functions of these keys as we conduct an actual testing of devices or equipment. And last, we have the current terminal, COM terminal, and voltage terminal. It is where the test leads will be connected. How does this measuring instrument work? Let's connect the two test leads. Red test lead to volt and black test lead to COM. As you can see, the leads are color-coded, and it has protective caps. These test leads can be used under the CAT2, CAT3, and CAT4 environments by attaching a protective cap. These are the measurement category. Oh, circuits which are not directly connected to the main power supply. CAT2, these are primary electrical circuits of equipment connected to an AC electrical outlet by a power cord. CAT3, these are primary electrical circuits of equipment connected to the distribution panel, and feeders from the distribution panel to outlets. CAT4, the circuit from the service drop to the service entrance, and to the power meter and primary overcurrent protection device at distribution panel. Let's do the voltage measurement. First, set it to AC volt range, let's see what the voltage rating of our outlet will be. Be careful in conducting an actual testing. Press hold key in less than a second, the LCD shows H mark and the reading will be held. The reading is 223.2 volts. Press the hold key in less than a second again, to release the display. How about the backlight function? Press the backlight key 1 second or longer to turn on the backlight. Press the backlight key again 1 second or longer to turn off the backlight. The light automatically turns off in 1 minute mark. To get the minimum and maximum reading values, press the max min key 1 second or longer to start recording the maximum and minimum values. Then the LCD shows the latest maximum value 223.2 volts. By pressing max min key less than 1 second, the minimum value is 222.5 volts. To disable this function, press the max min key 1 second or longer. How about the select key function? Set your multimeter to ACV, and press select key less than a second to put it in a frequency or duty measurement. The frequency is at 60.04 or 60 Hz and duty cycle at 50%. Next, set it to DC volt range, connect the red test lead to positive supply terminal and black, COM, test lead to negative supply terminal of a battery. The reading is 9.71 volts. What if the connection is reversed? The negative mark will be displayed on the LCD, negative 9.71 volts. Next, set our multimeter to ohm meter range. There are 4 sets of measurement available. Resistance checking, diode measurement, capacitance measurement, and continuity check. In resistance measurement, an omega sign will appear on the LCD. Let's check the coil resistance of this magnetic contactor. The reading shows 389.1 ohms for the magnetic coil. Press select key 1 to toggle the other functions. In diode measurement, a diode symbol will appear on the display. In continuity checking, an omega sign plus a sound symbol will appear on the display. For example, let's test the auxiliary normally closed contact as if it's still intact. When you heard the beat sound coming from the multimeter, it means it is still in good condition. And last, capacitance measurement. A nanofarad symbol will appear on the LCD. Let's proceed to ammeter range. There are 2 sets, AC ammeter and DC ammeter. Set it to AC current measurement. In a current measurement, the multimeter must be connected along the electrical circuit. Please check the test leads if these are placed properly. Red test lead must be placed in a terminal of the multimeter while black test lead at COM terminal. After properly setting up the multimeter, our test leads will be connected in between A2 terminal of the 220 volt coil magnetic contactor going to line 2 of the main supply voltage. Switch on the circuit breaker, 0.033 ampere or 33 milliamperes is displayed in the LCD. As for DC current measurement, our test leads will be connected in between A2 terminal of the 24 volt DC coil magnetic contactor going to line 2 of the main supply voltage. Switch on the circuit breaker, 0.146 ampere or 146 milliamperes is displayed in the LCD. Now, given that you properly installed the devices and components, you must conduct a pre-testing using the multimeter, right? These are the procedures you are going to make during motor control activities. Make sure that all voltage supply is cut off. Step 1. Resistance measurement. Check the resistance at line 1 and line 2 of the control circuit. It is expected to read the coil resistance of the magnetic contactor. Good. And Step 2. Voltage measurement. Be aware of what kind of voltage that you are going to test. Then, check the supply voltage passing through the circuit breaker. Good. So, that's all on how to use our digital multimeter. If you find this video interesting and useful to others, you may consider subscribing, like and share and hit the notification bell for more updates to come. And follow us at Facebook page, Warden's Corner. See you on next video tutorials. Have a nice day ahead. Thank you and goodbye.